Hi there, and this is the little tuition video I've done for the first 16 bars of the Trinity College London Grade 7 song Bolero. I thought just having a look at these first few bars would give a good insight into the techniques that are very good for us to use, especially for our right hand here, on trying to get a great sound for what we're trying to play. Really good what we call articulation of the notes. So all the notes are really clear. In this case, it's fundamentally smooth. There's no staccato notes. But what we're really trying to do is get these arpeggios really clean, really nice to listen to. So no over-ringing of notes from previous chords, or just ringing through. We want a nice clear sound at the start of nearly like almost every beat as the chords change. So the first thing to do in bar one, we're just going to look actually at those two chord shapes. So I've got an A minor chord shape and I form that at the start. So normally at the start of every new chord shape that's appearing within a bar even, I'm going to form those chord shapes. I'm not just going to let them layer up by putting one finger to down. And the next one is the D minor chord shape. Now I've used finger one on the F, two for the A, and finger four for the D. The reason I do that is because, like, from experience, we know a lot of songs, the kind of finger three will be end up using for some of these bass notes here. So that's the reason I do it. You can use that there, that finger three, but maybe good to start thinking about, you know, although I don't think it's specifically needed at the moment, but it's a good fingering to use, one, two, and four. However, it's like a lot of things, it's your choice. Okay, so I've got the A minor shape. The most important thing is here, I'm doing a full plant. Okay, so I call it a full plant. So I've got thumb on five, and then my index, middle, and A fingers on 3, 2, 1. And I've planted those down. I've grabbed the strings, if you like. For the first arpeggio, I'm going to go thumb, thumb, I am A. Okay, what you can hear is I'll just kind of repeat that arpeggio. Okay, I've got a string six ringing away as well there, which I didn't want. But the thing is, that's the guitar, so that's going to ring on anyway. But what happens is we get a clear attack, a clear level of articulation at the start of each little set of arpeggios. Oh, I missed the one. What we're really after, a nice clean articulation. So the rhythm, one and a, two and three, A and A. I often just call these like black current, two and semi-quaver, you know, just using some words, some rhythms to help me synchronize my left hand to my thinking. I'll go nice and slow. It's not really fast, this song, anyway, but let's just see what we get. So again, I've done a full plant when I get to that D minor. And that means I cannot go wrong with my fingering here on my right hand. So I get. Okay, so I just played a little bit extra there, but we get the idea what's going on. So full planting on the A minor to start with. Full plant for the D minor, yeah. Back to the A minor. Oh, played the wrong notes there. That should have been that. Okay, an E7 chord. Right, so get that right hand down, full planted, get your rhythms correct, and you cannot go wrong when your left hand is already formed and your right hand is on the correct strings. It works wonders. So that will take us to bar four, actually, because the second part's just a repeat, which we could just do like a little echo effect. It says MP, so it says quieter, so a little echo effect. Okay, so now let's just look at that next part, bar five. If I ignore the little trill that's going on there, What I've got is A, A and C. And then I'm going to swap to my thumbs because I'm going to go down low notes. So I'm just going to use my thumbs here. I've got the chord, then G, F, E with finger one. I'm going to use finger one there. That allows me to bring finger two for that chord, the D, A and B. Finger three, yeah, for the C. And then that allows me to fingers four and two to play that little chord, B and F. Continue with my thumb. I'll ignore the trill again at the moment. A, G, F, E chord. Okay, and that's repeating. And again, it's like an echo effect. Right, so very important, I think, here to get the correct fingerings and the use of the thumb. One and two and three and... Okay, so I'll go nice and slowly to take that through again. We've got the chord to start off with. Then my trill, I'm going to use my thumb for the G up to the A back to the G. Finger one, E. Finger two for the A there. Finger three, then fingers two and four can just come here. Trill on the A up to the B and back to A. F, E, a G, F, E chord. Okay, then we've got a repeat. Yeah, just to mention in the first chord there in bar five, A, A and C, even though that A is written like as an offset, the middle voice there, that's just done for clarity. Okay, it's just telling us that the middle voice is going to do a run. We've got a high melody note being held, yeah, a low bass, and then a middle voice. And I'm trying to hold that C as long as I can. Sometimes my fingers just get stuck on it, just touch that string and stop it. But ideally, I'd like it to ring on. Yeah, it kind of diminishes after a bit, but if we can hold it for a bit, that's good. So that's our run. It's repeated. Okay, and then we've got a little repeat of some of the bars. Oh no, it happens, it actually changes in bar nine. Yeah, so I just bring finger four out, see. Hold the chord. Finger four, semi quaver. Okay, there we go, that's your A. Now, the editor here in bar 10, 8, 9, 10, yeah. They put some fingerings. I'm just going to give you some different ones, okay? And I'll explain why. We've got an E, and then it goes to F sharp and G sharp. Could even do a little glissando there. Okay, that's nice if you use the finger one. You could use any finger to do the glissando, but... And what that does, that finger one is acted as a guide. Now finger three acts as a guide for me to get to that B. And it's all on the same string, so we get the same tonality. Yeah. All using the same string, same tonality, really nice. B, A, B, C. Yeah, so B is the octave at the 12th fret, A fret 10, C fret 11. Yeah, A, B, C, A, B, C. Yeah, you just go up five frets, A, B, C. Fret 5, fret 10, A, B, C. There you go. So now you can replicate those notes that are on string 1. I think using the same tonality is a great idea. It also means that you're using the same string to guide yourself, so you're not crossing the strings and any confusion. So why not let's use that principle? So let's just try that. So we've had 1, 2, and 3, and... Okay, I needed a low E in there as well. So 1, 2, and 3, and 1, and 2, and 3, and... Okay, so just a little mistake. There should have been the A bass on beat 3 at the end of the line there. Just counting, that is. That's all it's counting. 1, and 2, and 3, and... You can see the A's are on 1, 2, 3, and then we've got that syncopated feeling with notes on the offbeats. 1, and 2, and 3, and... Okay. Now we're going to swap strings because we're going to play E, D, F. Okay, lemonade, I call that rhythm. Ta-ta-ta. Okay, let's just get that back. So we get 1, 8, and 2. Okay, and that 2 would be then that string 4D. Okay, let's add a bass in there. So we've got 1, 8, and 2. 1, 8, and 2. Okay, so be clear about your E, D, F, fret 13. 1, 8, and... Okay, now let's look at this run. Beat 2 starts off with a D because we've got a tied F. I won't just tie it at the moment, I'll make it clearer. So then it's just a rundown. D, E, C, B, A, G, F. Okay, let's get to that F there. So I get 2, A, and A, 3, A, and... Sorry. 2, A, and A, 3, A, and A. Okay, that's good. So now we're clear, and it's just a rundown. Semi-quaver, semi-quaver. Okay, if we do it in semi-quaver rhythm, like talking like it. Now then, this is again, I change, I think, the fingerings a little bit here because I'm going to take finger 2, fret 9 for the next bar. Okay, got two E's. And I'm going to form a little chord here. C, finger 2, 3, E, finger 4. Little backwards triangle shape there. So it's an A minor chord. Okay, and I can add finger 1 on fret 8 for a high C. So this chord is really like a D minor. Form down here. Move it up to fret 8, finger 1 on fret 8, and then add the C there. And it just becomes an A minor chord. So I get now the two E's. 1, 1. Sorry, 1 and 2A. Okay. Black current 2A. Black current 2A. Get to that harmonic nice and quick. Okay, that's on the and of beat 2. So now I get this. 1 and a 2 a and 3. And now that's on the and 3 and. That's when I get the E seventh chord again. So take your time with that bit. Learn where those notes are and learn how to count them doing the runs. Okay, so we got this bar 12. So we get 1 a and, 1 a and, 2 a and a, 3 a and a. Yeah. Did I play a B flat there? I wasn't sure. It should have been B natural, if, just in case I played it wrong. 1 a and, 2 a and a, 3 a and a. Okay, now I've got confused whether I was or not, but I won't edit the video anyway, but it's B natural. Finger 2 on there, on the E, form the C and the A next to them straight away, and that allows you to go 1 A and A, 1 A, 1 and A, 2 A, quickly to there and down. Okay, then you've got a repeat of beginning parts that were at the beginning of the song on bars 14, 15 and 16, and then I'll do a separate video for bar 16 onwards to encompass some of those. So good luck with that. Remember the right hand planting technique, yeah, left hand forming chords and getting clear articulation of the notes. Okay, so good luck with those.